Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, on Ancient Isles, the first map of the semi-final. Oh, wait a second. Okay, of the semi-final. Between the two Ukrainian Night Elf powerhouses. Foggy, I told you before, he was supposed to play the WCA LAN tournament in Cologne, but was his visa got denied. So still one of the best Night Elves we have here in Europe, together with Warchief Sonic and Rudin, of course. But on the other hand, we have the guy who won the Zodiac Dream League, who bought an iron door with his prize money, and the guy who dethroned Warchief Rich from the Jera throne after the first hat trick in Warcraft history for Jera Cup. He won it three times in a row, but no quadruple win or whatever it's called. So no fourth time in a row win, because Sonic is currently the Jera Cup champion until tomorrow, when there's Jera Cup 28. So yeah, Demon Hunter on both sides of the battlefield. We have strange Engine of War positions here. Usually you plant it here, right next to this little orange spot. But Sonic is going for the natural expansion, and Foggy is going for this little creep camp here. Twisted Meadows creep spot with the two Warden and the one Overseer. And okay, Foggy with the second Engine of War already, investing a lot into it. Maybe he's massing. Sonic with a very early Huntress haul. Okay. This is weird. This is odd. But let's see how things unfold. What can you do afterwards? You can't go to a shop with the Engine of War. You can take this one. But I think this creeping of Sonic so far is a little better. You can advance to the shop and then later to the mercenary camp, but we'll see what these two pro players have in their sleeves. Firebrand and Painkiller. Ring of Regeneration, a superb item for Sonic. Level 2 for him, and Foggy almost level 2. So no evasion creep on this one. Don't really know why he did it, why he took this spot so early. With just the Circle of Nobility, he would have gotten the same item here. So I don't really see the reason, but okay. I'm waiting for it. Yeah, and Sonic, he can build the first Huntress. Foggy is a little late, but he stays on, both players stay on tier 1. Go for Huntresses here, so most likely not a usual Bear Mirror. And Foggy again, just like in the game against Trunks, placing an Engine of War, but this time he has a more experienced player to deal with, and he just counters it with an Engine of War of his own. That's yeah, the most easy thing to do, I guess, because you can always repair it. And yeah, that's why you win the fight, Engine of War versus Engine of War. Oh, nice block by Foggy, but not enough. Definitely not enough. Yeah, with the Huntress support, everything's good. But okay, no expansion, but there's a Wisp in place. No attempt of an expansion for Foggy. Both players are going for Huntress. There's Mass Huntress versus Single Huntress. But soonish there's a second Engine of War for Sonic, so yeah. A long tier 1 game, most likely. With mass heal scrolls and mass protection scrolls. That's always important in this one. Okay, Foggy's Engine of War is done. And he got a nice timing. Ooh, almost getting this Huntress. And if he can keep up the pressure, he's definitely forcing Sonic into a town portal. But he's damaged, down to 50% HP. So I don't really know if this is worth it. Here, what is Foggy accomplishing? He may get a Moon Will. Is it enough repair? Nope, it's not. Sonic lost the Moon Will. That's a biggie. But okay, Foggy has the same faith. Repair too late. And now the Wisps, yeah, against Huntress. Easy pickings for a Demon Hunter Huntress combination. Nice harass on both sides, maybe a base trade. And they'll start over again right after the, I don't know, 7 or 8 minute mark. Who has to town portal first? That's the big question. Second moon well down. Foggy is doing a great job harassing here. And Sonic, I don't know, can't really defend this one. Well, he does good damage to the Demon Hunter, but he's not preventing the damage. And this Moonwell is still alive, and the Demon Hunter down to 50 HP. Oh, Foggy, town portals, and there must be an immediate counter town portal. Yeah, Mana Burn would have killed him, so easy enough. Wow, what an early game. What an early game in a Night Elf Mirror. Level 3 now for Sonic's Demon Hunter. Level 2 for Foggy. And yeah, level 2.5, so he's way behind. Let's take a look at the units here. 4 Hunters on each side. But Sonic has 13 Wisps. Okay, and Foggy only 7. He will get lumber problems with only 2 lumber wisps. Sonic did a good job killing them. And of course delaying, I don't know, a possible tech or whatever. But no. Sonic's still waiting for his second Engine of War. And so the problem is he can't produce as fast as his opponent does. And if he's able to only pump out Huntress, then he doesn't need that much wood. Maybe that's the big chance for Foggy here. Once again, dealing good damage to the Demon Hunter. Moonwell, or, yeah, one Moonwell is down, one Moonwell to go. Now it's 8 versus 5 Huntress. Oh shit, Sonic is losing this one. So, the advantage of Foggy grows by the second. He has twice the Huntress count. No more dust here, but okay, yeah, Sonic has dust, but that's not enough. A player's forces are under attack. Everything is damaged, and there's no Moonwells here, no expansion, no nothing. And Foggy is trying it again with Engine Protectors. If you saw the Golden Cup today, he tower rushed Hawk in a crazy game on Echo Isles, which may be the next replay of the week. But yeah, we'll see. Okay, first Engine Protector is down, but he'll just do it again. He has enough Huntress. He can continue with this game. Moonwell's in good shape, I guess. A player's forces are under not dropping the circlet. Too dangerous for a steal. Look at this massive Huntress army. The supply is the same, strangely. But he has 5 Huntress more. 5. And Sonic, yeah, he tried to get the second Engine of War up, but this will not work. I think the only chance that Sonic has is killing the Demon Hunter now. Oh, it looks good for him, but he escapes. And he gets the level up, and now he's safe with the Heal Scroll in his main base. He's once again scared away by 9 Huntresses. Finally, the first Engine Protector is up, so it's 8 Huntresses. And now, yeah, he needs to focus. 7 Huntress. Nice, brave Engine Protector. But what's going on with the heroes here? Still 88 HP. There is boots for Sonic, so he will always be fast and always can get a hit or two. Mass repair coming in. He has so much lumber, he can easily afford it. And in the meantime, he's killing Huntress after Huntress after Huntress. And yes, Foggy is realizing that and is retreating. So Sonic stabilizes. Dangerous change of directions here. And now Foggy has problems. He lost his high Huntress count to nothing because the Engine Protector is still up. He threw Sonic back a bit, but not too much. Sonic could even tech now. Ring around the Tree of Life. And maybe he can trap the Demon Hunter or surround it, but everything is low. Yeah, he tries to go for a surround, but that's just an invitation to finish the Huntress. Wow, I'm impressed by Sonic. How calm he stayed during that that siege. A player's forces are under attack. And now Foggy feels like a DK. Wow, he even has to pull the Invo Potion. He feels like a DK on tier 1, not able to heal, down with 25 HP. And now he is losing his second production building. Okay, what's Sonic doing? Just producing, right? Yeah, getting the second engine back. GG 1-0 for the Zodiac Dream League winner. Who would have thought that? This completely backfired. And now... wow, with a back against the wall, Sonic one step away from the final of the Back to Warcraft ladder contest. Amazing good! Yes. Yeah, I think the key to victory for Sonic was the one entry protector with three last hits. Twisted Meadows is next. Hoo 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 hoo. Interesting, interesting, interesting. Yeah, I think Foggy's Mirror is not that good. Oh, fuck, I forgot the game name. I really... okay, okay. There we are. Wolf is in, Foggy is in, just waiting for Sonic. Alright. See if they keep the colors. I think so. Wrong map by High Tech. High five, High Tech. Maybe a misclick or mistypo or whatever. So, what's going on in the chat? Yeah, it's this one. What's the plugin that shows unit workers, etc.? It's Dream Dota, but I think you will not be able to download it anywhere anymore. Okay, Riddler, just send us a mail, like the bot says. We still have some shirts left. Where's Remo? I have no idea what Remo is doing. Got no response from Remo whatsoever. We chatted 2 days ago, I guess, and he was like, Diablo 3 hype is all gone. I hate this fucking game. So boring. And then we talked a bit about music, and he showed me his, I don't know, crazy rapper stuff. And I didn't really listen, and then he stopped responding. That's it. Yeah, maybe he is searching his bike. That's right. That's absolutely a possible answer to this question. Okay, and we can start the next game, or the game is already started. It is Twisted Meadows, everybody. Maybe, yeah, this is a good map for Mass Huntress Tower Rush again. But yeah, in the lower left of TM we see Sonic. He has the 1-0 lead in this semi-final. And in the lower right we have Foggy, who needs to win this one desperately to stay alive in this tournament and keep his chance alive to advance to the grand final. Foggy with a better start position because he's closer to the mercenary camp. But Sonic immediately scouts it and he pulls the creeps. Is it enough? Is it enough or not? Oh yeah, Sonic is doing great job with the aggro. But counter-pulling by Foggy. Here comes the Wisp again. Ah, he's only able to get the troll. And not more. Woohoohoo, this was really close. Great job from Foggy. Reacting so fast, but here comes the second Wisp. No Ancient of War from Sonic yet. He changed his game. He will go and contest this creep spot. Wow, tension right from the start. Or is he going for an engine of war here? He is, right? Oh boy. He doesn't have enough lumber. He needs more lumber. More creep pulling. He built the moonwell to cancel the aggro. That cost him a little. Okay, now he has gold for the engine of war. Lumber for the engine of war. What's he doing with it? Nothing just yet.
A town is under siege.
Okay, this one had to be dispelled. So no crazy engine of war. No engine of war at all. Maybe he's just going for fast tech or something. And okay, Foggy is mind tricking him. Not going for the spot just yet, because of course he knows that Sonic knows. Okay, Mass Huntress, yes. Mass Huntress, but no Huntress Hall from Sonic. Demon Huntress exchanging blows. But of course, Foggy in a better position so far. Ah, this is Foggy's. Okay, so, oh my god, what's up with my brain? Foggy and Sonic both going for one engine of war, so this is not Mass Huntress, definitely not. But it's interesting, and Sonic is in a bad situation because he can't produce, his engine of war is under pressure, and he will have to face an engine of war soonish, and his Demon Hunter is low. I don't see him winning this, to be honest. Demon Hunter gets away, but he has no access to Moonwells anymore. Two are empty, and the third is about to finish. He needs this. Like, 5 more seconds or something. Okay, there it is. Back in the base. And his Engine of War is up. So important now. Mass Repair coming in. There's only one Demon Hunter to defend his entire base from Sonic. But it seems to be enough. With this hero on low HP, it seems to be enough. But he has tree support now. And the mighty left and right hands. Sonic is losing economy here. The so important economy. Both players tacking now. Sonic once again without a production building. Is the pressure high enough to win Foggy the game? Or will this just count custom resources that hurt him in the end? I'm not sure. But I think it looks very, very grim for Sonic. He's trapped in his own base. The moonwells are all dry. He needs to reposition with the town portal. Is he going for the Demon Hunter or something? No, just in a safe position. But there's nothing. There's nothing. Player's forces are under attack. He's waiting for the shop, but he's not in tier 2, so no heal potions. There's no reaction to this, like in the base or something. He's trying to rebuild. And leaves without a GG! The pressure was too high. And so we have the equalizer here in this semi-final. We will need a third game. And the map is... I'm not so sure. Didn't really take notice of this. Last map was... LR, I guess. Okay, next map is the Last Refuge. what a easy way, but good adaption from Foggy to not desperately go for this mercenary camp creep spot. But to heavily pressure the main base of Sonic, who had no answer to this. He was too greedy, not building the Engine of War, trying to tech, like, super early. That backfired hard. Okay, Okay, Sonic ready, Foggy ready. The pros know how to deal with the situations. Okay, we start once again. Oh, Jesus, why is it not updated? I don't get it. Some bug in this program. Okay, deciding map. Which Ukrainian Night Elf player will advance to the finals and will most likely meet Imperius? Well, I think it's kind of blasphemy to say most likely, but we'll see about that. So, this is fairly standard. Sonic and Foggy both going for the shop creep. Could go for mercenary, but I think it's not the right choice to do. Okay, let's see if you post something in the chat. Neo, did the Europe vs. Korea tourney happen yesterday? Not really. The qualifier for Brains Walker 3 Cup happened yesterday. And Watch If Rich won and Sheik. Or Shike, I'm not really sure how to pronounce it, to be honest. And the VODs are already up on our YouTube. You can find it there. There's the playlist, Rust Brain Cup number 2, qualifier number 2. In 1080p, 60 FPS. Bam! Production value, yo! Neo, you look like no party yesterday. No, I went to play a little Diablo and then I went to sleep. So I'm very relaxed today to cast this tournament. 200 bucks on the line! Don't forget that. Even the bronze medal winner gets 40 bucks. And of course, all of you can win a mechanical keyboard by Lioncast. You know the deal. Go over to their Facebook page and post thank you for supporting Back to Warcraft on their timeline. So enough chit-chat. Let's focus on the game. We see the first creep by Sonic and Foggy is once again super aggressive, but the big potion and the experience go to Sonic, and the circle go to Sonic as well, so his position is great. Foggy countered it with a parry of fatality, and Sonic needs to be careful with his Engine of War. There's so much damage. Maybe the Demon Hunter should switch his focus, but no, it's enough. It's enough. Sonic loses his AOW once again, so he needs to kill it. Invu potion. Oh, nice. He forced him into the Invu potion, only paid 100 and whatever for this parry of fatality, and once again pressuring him with the Ancient of War. Oh, this is a dangerous situation for Sonic. Foggy needs to keep his Demon Hunter alive, and then he has all the good cards in his hands to play them out one after another. There's no chance to contest the Engine of War. Parry is expensive? I thought it would only be 100 and whatever. It's not more, like, it's not over 200, right? A player's forces are under attack. 300 gold for a Pariept? Holy shit! I didn't know that. Okay, that is expensive. Oh boy. Ah, yeah, I think I was thinking about the selling value. Wow, 350, crazy. Okay, so once again, the same situation as always in Foggy Mirrors nowadays. Two Engines of Wars in the base, one of Foggy, one of Sonic. And yeah, so heavy pressure to Sonic again. I think he... Yeah, the big thing is, do I move my tree up to counter... To counter Foggy's Engine of War or not? Well, there's a tech by two players, and Foggy is wildly ahead. Two more hits. Maybe a mana burn. That's not enough. And now the moon will save them once again. I really like this Demon Hunter skirmish. This is entertaining. And now Foggy has... Yeah, Foggy would need something to support his Engine of War. Maybe it's just a distraction or whatever to then punish him with an early tier 2 push or something, but no. So I think it's time to slow down a bit. The early games here were really, really intense. In the two maps prior.
A player's forces are under attack.
But yeah, we have the Huntress Hall. The tech looks good for Foggy. He has the Naga now, and this is time to deal damage. This is really the time to deal damage. No tier 2 for like 50 seconds for Sonic. No Naga for a minute. And his Huntress Hall pretty vulnerable, even though it's well built. The AOW is down, by the way. But it paid off. If you can pay that early, then the investment paid off. And Foggy once again with a nice creeping. But it's only creeping. It's doing nothing to Sonic except like stealing this creep spot from him.
Player's forces are under attack.
And there's no ancients yet. No tier 2 buildings. Only now building the lore. Where did he spend all his money on? Or is it the lumber problem again? No, he has lumber enough. He's doing crazy things again. Strange things again. Rock Golem going down. Oh, Robe of the Magi. Not the best item, but he lost the Ancient of War. Yeah, I'm not sure what Foggy is doing.
Player's forces are under attack.
What the hell? Why did he do that? Okay. Foggy is not going for the aggressive with the Naga, but he steals all the creep camps. This one, and this one. So that's like the three creep camps you'd usually do with your second hero. And he completely denies Sonic that experience. So he did do the Merc camp, but what now? He has only the laboratory left on his side of the map and the red spot. And now, with all calmness, Foggy could also creep his side of the map or now try to push. Sonic with a second Engine of Lore. And Foggy with a... I don't know, man. But his tier 3 tech. Maybe he skips Dryad completely. Or just builds one. So one Engine of Lore is enough until tier 3. And because of that, he favors the tier 3 tech over the second lore. Could be a reason. Okay, I was kind of distracted, I'm so sorry, but that push failed. He accomplished nothing. And I'm not so sure, man. He gets level 2 with his Keeper of the Grove. The Keeper of the Grove will later definitely be the better hero for Sonic, with the aura especially. Maybe he should have gone for the dots. But I'm saying this every game and I can't change it. So all he has now is the tech, I guess. Right?
A player's forces are under attack.
Yeah. Half attack ahead. Sonic really needs to drag this game in the long run, I guess. Three bears already. Upgrades coming. He can't really fight now. I don't know if he doesn't expect Foggy to have this great tech. Or he thinks, okay, I killed a second hero, this is the time for me to push. But it definitely isn't. 5 seconds and Master Bear is here. Everything is protected. Moonwills are kind of full. And here's Sonic Mana burning the Keeper of the Grove right away. Hitting it hard, but Book of the Dead's around! Oh my god! He needs this spell. Okay, he has Staff. He has Staff. He learned from the mistake against Tale of Anger, I guess. Maybe I was a little too excited about this and I forgot about the Staff. But it was a cool move. It definitely was a cool move. I thought he had to pull a wisp and then take a lot of damage, but yeah. Still does good damage, the archers, and Foggy cannot go out there with his bears. He needs rejuvenation on the Demon Hunter, battling it out. Sonic for 2 Dryads here. And he has Master. Foggy has Master Bears. Master Bears versus Mass Range and Mercs and whatever. The bears should pay off sooner than later. Yeah, exactly, and Sonic has to tempo out. There's no healing anymore, and the bears are just too strong. Okay, I think this game is open again for both sides, but yeah, now Sonic can catch up. He has a good dispel, and he has Master Bears now. But he has not a single bear on the battlefield. Here's the first one. But in the meantime, Foggy can creep more, and he can creep with ease now with Rejuvenation. So, healing wards. It's okay. If placed correctly later in the bear versus bear fight, this item can be huge. Huge difference for Foggy, but I don't think we'll see that. Where did the shop go? Kinda lost it. Why is Sonic experience so high?
A player's forces are under attack.
Okay, that's level 3 Naga, I see. Okay, first red spot, or at least just the Ogre Lord. Is he able to steal it? No, he's just invulnerable. Not like a Blade Master where there's no collision anymore. Agility and intelligence, Hood of Cunning. Not the best item he can get. Of course, hoping for the Vampire Aura. Foggy now. Did he creep the Merc Camp? Okay, he's doing it now. Invul Potion, Heal Potion, that would be huge for him. Maybe even Mana Potion for the Naga. Maybe.
A town is under siege. A player's forces are under attack.
But Sonic gets both red spots. That's a big thing. Sonic knows exactly what's going on. The Invis Potion should... Yeah, it's definitely remains until the possible last hit. Let's see if he gets the item or the last hit. I think he's out of position. Wow, mana burn. He gets the hit. Here he is. And he gets Kaka's Pipe of Insight. Very nice. Well done. Okay, now he invested 2 items for that. But Kaka's Pipe is worth it, I guess. More Roar, more Reju, more Fork Lightning, more Frost Arrow. And more dispel. But claws plus 9 now. Okay, let's check the inventories. Foggy has 1 heal scroll and heal wards. He has 3 and 4 hero. Fork Lightning level 2 will hit very, very hard. Second heal scroll now. No invo potion, mind you. Sonic has an invo potion and 1 heal scroll. Okay, unit composition. Six bears. Sonic has a way lower bear count, and this might be it for the fight. We'll see. Yeah, Sonic already damaged. There's no roar on Foggy's bears. I think they are completely out of position here. What's he doing? Demon Hunter is chasing the ward. That was important. But yeah, still two heal scrolls there. Next Fog Lightning hitting. No heal scroll anymore for Sonic. Invo Potion being used on his Demon Hunter. He's kind of trapped there. Foggy going rampage! Staff saves the first hero for now. But Sonic is doing good for the bear count, I guess. But now there's level 4 Demon Hunter with level 2 evasion. And he will last hit one bear after another. One is down. Two is down. Mana burn again on the Keeper of the Grove. So he's like completely useless. He's just crawling through the army of Sonic. And it gets worse and worse and worse and worse for him. Without... Okay, he has one bear left, but will this be enough? I don't think so. It's 50 food versus 47, and now he's taking care of the Demon Hunter staffed again. But the moon well should all be dry since it's daytime. Oh, it just became daytime. Yeah, great situation to fight for Sonic. For Foggy, sorry. Two heal scrolls ahead, two bears ahead, good position. Everything's okay. No mana anymore on the Naga for Fog Lightning, but there's healing on the Demon Hunter. That's all you need, basically. But Sonic's staffing game is good. Saving units here and there. And now Foggy is pushing over 50 food. He is producing bears and bears and bears. He wants to capitalize from this advantage he has now. And it's day for so long. 9 hours of daytime. 9 hours of no mana regeneration at the Moon Worlds. And there will always be redo because there's Katka's Pipe of Insight. Only two bears left, one bear left, and now he dives maybe a little too far. No, he stops the dive, taking care of the production buildings. That's all good. The advantage will just increase. Or is he committing too much? One bear down. Ah, this should be safe. This should be a safe win for Foggy now. But you never know from Sonic. You never know what this crazy guy is thinking, but two level 5 heroes against 4 and 3. This sends a message, and the message is... the message is killing the Demon Hunter? No. Sonic left the game, and Foggy advances to the grand final. Wow! That was an impressive push. That was definitely some push here. And... yeah, Foggy in the grand final, Sonic in the game for third. And Night of Mirror can be fun once again.